This one is, I need help in understanding how to code the following. Now, these are three diagnoses, the way I took this question, three diagnoses on one encounter, one patient. And the three are acute exacerbation of COPD or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, acute bacterial exacerbation of chronic bronchitis, and asthma with exacerbation. Now, our coder is stating I would code this with 493.22 only, which is chronic obstructive asthma with acute exacerbation. She or he, the coder is stating that the coworkers would code this with 491.22 and 493.22. I don't understand how you can get acute bronchitis out of exacerbation of chronic bronchitis. Any help would be greatly appreciated. And this can be very confusing, the acute and the chronic, especially when you've got a disease process that is so similar. So what I did was I took the two codes and just put them up here. So 493.22 states chronic obstructive asthma with acute exacerbation. And so that's a specific code with, you know, you can have chronic obstructive asthma without the acute exacerbation. And then we have 491.22, obstructive chronic bronchitis with acute bronchitis. The point that I think that will help the coder that's asking this is understanding a little bit about the disease process. First of all, you might wonder, well, how come we're not coding COPD? Because that was the first thing listed. Actually, when you have these other two the diagnoses, if you note down where this is what you get when you look up COPD 496, down here on the bottom, it states, note, this code is not to be coded with any code from categories 491 through 493. And both of those other codes are 49 are in that range. So we're not going to code the COPD, right? We are going to code just for the asthma and the bronchitis. Now, the question was, you know, how come we're coding for both of those? You know, how are we getting an acute out of a chronic condition? The fact is, it's very common. A chronic condition means that it just doesn't go away. We always have it. Now, I'll use myself as an example for this because this just really is right up my alley. I've had asthma since I was a child. Asthma is actually a condition in which the airways, they narrow and then they swell, all right? And then what happens is your body starts producing extra mucus and phlegm because of the irritation. And then your airway is just kind of constricted. I would like to say at a lower level, you know, down in your lungs, all right? Okay, but bronchitis is a little different. Bronchitis is actually an inflammation. Now, that doesn't mean you don't get inflammation with the asthma, but it's not the same disease actually here. So asthma is swelling, and anything can set off that swelling. It could be an allergy. It could be having an anxiety attack. It could be getting choked on something, which happens to me. It could be walking too far or running, and all of a sudden everything starts swelling up because it's a condition that you have. Unlike bronchitis, where something has to irritate the bronchial passages to make them swell and start producing mucus, okay? But they're inflamed, thus the itis at the end of bronchitis. Now, bronchitis affects the bronchial passages. I just happen to have bronchial asthma. You can have asthma down inside the lungs, or you can have it actually in different parts of the lung, but mine commonly hits the bronchial passages, so I have bronchial asthma. So it is actually two separate conditions, and my asthma is chronic. Do I get a flare up once in a while? Yes, and that would be classified as an acute exacerbation. This happens often for me in the springtime, just like everybody else when all the pollen starts to fall. Unlike most people that have just kind of like an allergy attack, I will have an asthma attack, which means it's not an inflammation. It just means that those passages close up. And then because they start to close, they produce mucus. All right. Now, if you get bronchitis, you've either got a virus or bacteria's gotten in there, and then you have an inflammation. Two separate diseases, so therefore you need two separate codes. Can you have one without the other? Yes. Can you have them both at the same time? Absolutely. I'm a living proof of that, because my asthma goes into my bronchial passages and then it gets irritated and then it gets infected because it's raw and irritated, and then you get bronchitis. So yes, you do code both, and yes, you can have a chronic condition that's there. I have all these little inhalers that I keep with me all the time that my doctor tells me that I have to use all the time. That's to keep the passages open, right? So I live with that, but if it gets irritated, thus itis, then it's a different condition. Can I have an exacerbation? Absolutely, at any moment. You know, something could trip it off and I could have one right now in front of you. How exciting. But I won't do that for you for the webinar. We'd freak Boyd and Lorraine out. That's why you have the separate codes.
Yes,
very exciting, isn't it? That's it, guys.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.